Hello students, today we are going to discuss about the topic called heat sinks. So before going into the topic, so we should know about some basic concepts like thermal runaway and thermal resistance. Then only you can understand what is the use of heat sink. So let us quickly go into the thermal runaway concept. We all are know about transistor. This is the semiconductor representation of a transistor in which we can observe that the area of the collector is greater than the base and emitter regions. Collector region is very larger than the base region and emitter region. Why? The name itself, it is a collector which collects the electrons. So just see the operation of the transistor. So these electrons are emitted from the emitter and via base they are entering into the collector region. So in the collector there are more number of electrons. So at the junction of base and collector there are more number of electrons are passing. So because of that, as more electrons are entering into the collector region, more heat will get developed at the base collector junction. So if the heat is keep on increasing, then what happens? That heat will destroy the transistor. So that is nothing but thermal runaway. So we all are know about the equation for the collector current IC. IC is equal to beta times of IB plus 1 plus beta times of IC naught. So where IC is a collector current and beta is a forward current again, IB is the base current and IC naught is the reverse saturation current or leakage current. We know that here there are three variables in the equation beta, IB, IC naught. These all are varying variables which varies with the temperature. So if we leave the beta and IB, the IC naught is a very important variable which varies or else which increases double for every 10 degree centigrade rise. Okay, see the reverse saturation current or leakage current IC naught changes greatly with the temperature. Specifically, it doubles for every 10 degree centigrade rise in temperature. So that's why, so we must take concern about IC naught. So what happens if IC naught increases with the temperature? If IC naught increases with the temperature, then the equation for IC, the value of IC also increases. So IC means, the IC increasing means that the number of electrons entering into the collector region are increasing. If number of electrons entering into the collector region increases means more heat will get developed at the base collector junction. So this more heat will destroy the transistor. The collector current IC causes the collector base junction temperature to rise. This process will become cumulative, leading to thermal runaway. So if more heat, that heat is keep on increasing, so which destroys the transistor itself. So that because of that more heat, that junction will break out and the transistor will destroy itself. It won't work further. As the power transistors are working with more current, so there are more number of electron flow in the power transistors. That's why the heat developed in the power transistors is high when compared with the normal transistors. Okay, so the heat developed at the collector junction may be removed by use of a heat sink. So our intention is to remove that heat that was developed in the base collector region. Okay, so because of that we use a component called heat sink, so which is a metal sheet fitted to the collector and whose surface radiates heat quickly. So we are joining that metal part to our power transistor in order to eliminate or dissipate the heat developed at the junction. Okay, so that is the concept of thermal runaway as well as what is heat sink. Okay, let us quickly move into the thermal resistance. Consider a transistor used in a circuit where the ambient temperature of air around the transistor is TA degree centigrade. So ambient temperature means the temperature around the power transistor, which is like our environmental temperature. The temperature of the collector base junction of the transistor is given as TJ degree centigrade. So these two temperature values we have to remember. Here J represents the junction, T represents the temperature, here A represents ambient and T represents the temperature. So this is the environmental temperature and it is the junction temperature. So as the number of electrons are flowing into the collector region, there is some heat generating at the junction. Okay, so we know that the heat will transfer from hot body to the cold body. Okay, so definitely when the heat will dissipate from the junction, if the junction temperature TJ is greater than the ambient temperature, then only the temperature will transfer from the junction to the ambient. So then only the heat will get out. Okay, right. So due to heating within that transistor TJ, which is higher than the ambient temperature, so the junction temperature definitely higher than the surrounding temperature. So the junction temperature can be dissipated into the surroundings. Okay, as the temperature difference TJ minus TA is greater, the power dissipated in the transistor PD will be greater. Therefore, we can say the difference between the temperatures, junction temperature minus surrounding ambient temperature, is directly proportional to the power dissipation. So what is this power dissipation? So we know that the power dissipation is wastage of power in the form of heat. So when the transistor is not utilizing effectively, which means that it is not converting all DC power into the AC power, then that DC power will be wasted. Okay, so suppose if I give 1 watt as an input power for my transistor, but it is giving only half watt to the load, then the remaining half watt will be wasted in the form of heat in the power transistor. Okay, so that heating is called the power dissipation. Okay, so that the junction temperature minus ambient temperature is directly proportional to the dissipated power. So therefore, in order to eliminate the proportionality, we use one constant called theta. Therefore, where theta is the constant of proportionality and it is also called as thermal resistance. So this thermal resistance is different from one metal to another metal that will be given by the manufacturer. If we rearrange the above equation in order to get the thermal resistance theta, then theta is equal to TJ minus TA by PD. Therefore, what is the units for this thermal resistance? If you see, this thermal resistance is measured in degree centigrade for watt. So as the numerator is a temperature, it has the units degree centigrade, and the denominator is a power which has the units watt. That is what the units for the thermal resistance. As theta represents the total thermal resistance from a transistor junction to the ambient temperature, it is commonly referred as theta JA. So what is happening here? The heat developed at the junction is transferring from the junction to the ambient, to surrounding environment. So it is represented as thermal resistance between junction and ambient temperature. Okay, junction temperature to ambient temperature. However, for power transistor, thermal resistance is given from the junction to case. Junction to case. So what is this junction to case in the sense? So the junction is not directly visible to us. Okay, the power transistor was enclosed in a case. So some black material, some ceramic material is used as a case in order to close the power transistor semiconductor regions. So that is called as casing, so that the heat first transfer from junction to case. From the case, it is transferring to the ambient. That's why. So it can be represented as theta, junction and case. The amount of power that may be safely dissipated in the transistor is given by the power dissipated is equal to junction temperature minus ambient temperature divided by theta J to A, junction to ambient, or it can also be written as junction to case. Okay, the case is dissipating power to ambient temperature. The thermal resistance from the junction to ambience is considered to consist of two parts. As I told, the temperature developed at the junction is first transferring to the case first, then from the case to ambient it is transferring. Therefore, the theta JA, the thermal resistance between junction to ambient, can be written as thermal resistance between junction to case and case to ambient. So, which indicates that heat dissipated in the junction must make its way to surrounding air through the two series paths from the junction to case and from case to air. Hence, the power dissipated can be written as the power dissipated Tj minus Ta divided by theta Ja. This theta Ja can be written as theta J minus C plus theta Ca. Thermal resistance between junction to case is determined by the type of manufacturer. As I told, it is determined by the manufacturer, because which type of casing material he used, he only know that. Okay, so this will be given in the data sheet. From the case to ambient, the thermal resistance between case to ambient is determined by the surface area of the case or flange and its contact with air. The heat developed in the junction was transferred to the case first, and from the case it has to dissipate into air surrounding ambient. Okay, so that it will be determined by the surface area of the case. Okay, so if area is more, then it can dissipate the heat more quickly. If the area of this case is less, then it takes more time to dissipate the heat into the air. Okay, the case is also called as flange. If the effective surface area of the transistor case could be increased, the resistance to heat flow or theta case to ambient, thermal resistance from case to ambient, could be decreased. So that we can say, if the case area is more, then we can quickly dissipate the heat into the air so as to cool the junction in order to eliminate the thermal runaway. Therefore, the thermal resistance between junction to ambient can be written as thermal resistance between junction to the case first and case to ambient in parallel with thermal resistance between heat sink to ambient. So in order to increase the area of the case, we are using one extra component that is called heat sink, so that the heat can be dissipated into air via the heat sink. As the heat sink has more area, therefore we can dissipate more heat into the air. So why it is in parallel means the temperature entered into the case can directly dissipated into air, and also it can be dissipated via heat sink, so that these two thermal resistances are in parallel combination. As I told, in order to increase the effective area of the case, we have to use heat sink. So first of all, we will see what is heat sink. The heat sink is a relatively large finned, usually black metallic heat conducting device placed in close contact with a transistor case. So it is a metallic heat conducting device which is placed closed contact with transistor case. This heat sink is used to carry the heat to the surroundings, thereby avoiding the damage of transistor. So what are all the advantages if we use the heat sink? There are mainly two advantages. One is the temperature of the case gets lowered, so we can quickly decrease the temperature of the case. Okay, the second advantage, the power handling capability of the transistor can approach to the rated maximum value. If more heat is there, means the capability of the power transistor will decreases. That's why if we dissipate the power, then more power handling capability will be achieved. Let us see what are all the heat sink types. Okay, for low power transistor type, which means that small signal low power transistors can be mounted directly on metal chassis to increase the surface heat dissipation capability. So here, if we are using small signal low power transistors that can be mounted directly to the chassis. So what is this chassis means? If we are having some metal cabinet to our device, like a public addressing system, we have a metal case. That metal case itself called chassis. Okay, so in order to dissipate the power in that transistor, we will directly connect the transistor to that chassis. Therefore, the heat from the power transistor will be transferred to the chassis, metallic body of our equipment. Okay, so we can see there are many devices in your home, like a music system, so which is having metal body, that will get a heat up when we are using. So why this is happening means, so the heat in from the power transistors is transferred into that metal body. That metal body is using as heat sink in low power transistor type. But if we are using the chassis as heat sink, then we have to take care. Why? Because in very often collector of the transistor is connected to the transistor case to increase the heat dissipation capabilities. So in that small signal low power transistor, very oftenly there are only two output terminals we have. One is the emitter and base, and remaining collector is joined with the case of the transistor, so that we have to take more care about it. So let us understand that from this diagram. So this is a metal body or chassis of our equipment, and this is the power transistor case. So if you observe, in some cases there is no three leads for this transistor, like emitter, base, collector. Only they will give two leads. One is the emitter, another one is the base. The collector is connected to the metal case of our transistor. That time, if we directly connect this power transistor to metal chassis, most of the cases, this chassis is given to the ground terminal, so more power will be wasted and the device cannot be worked. Okay, so in order to eliminate this problem, so we have to use a beryllium oxide washer between the case and metal chassis of the equipment. Okay, so this beryllium oxide washer will act as a insulator between the case and metal chassis, and it will transfer the heat from case to chassis. Okay, so it will act as a insulator, but it can able to transfer the heat. So another type of heat sink is fin type heat sink or circular heat sink. So generally we use rectangular heat sink. So this is a circular type of heat sink. So when the transistor is mounted in Teflon sockets, it does not provide thermal conduction from transistor case to chassis. Therefore, a press on fin type of a black ionized heat sink may be used. So this type of circular or fin type heat sinks are preferred when the transistor is mounted in Teflon socket. We can easily understand from the following figure how the heat flow from the power transistor to ambient air via heat sink. So from this figure we can see this. This is the power transistor and this is the case of the transistor. Okay. The heat developed in the transistor is given in black color. This total component is the heat sink. The heat developed in the transistor is spreading over the heat sink and dissipated. So let us see this in a graphically. Okay, so here the heat developed in the power transistor is transferring to the heat sink panels and getting cooled. So here the red color in the sense heat, so blue color in the sense how it is getting cold while it is flowing through heat sink. Okay, let us recall some topics what we discussed in a power transistor heat sink. So the power dissipated from the power transistors are in order of hundreds of watts. There are only the two leads for emitter and base, but the case or the mounting flange of the case is collector terminal. So as we already discussed it, so as the case is collector, we have to insulate that from the heat sink or chassis. Okay, this can be done by using a insulating washer. So what is that insulating washer? We are using beryllium oxide washer. Okay, a special type of a heat sink which provides cooling by the conduction, convection and radiation is called power transistor heat sink. The thermal resistance of this heat sink is an order of 3 degrees centigrade per watt. Okay, let us see some heat sink diagrams. So this is the rectangular power transistor heat sink. So in these holes we will place some power transistors. So the heat will be dissipated in this power transistor heat sink. So these are the power transistors that are attached to heat sinks. So black metals are the heat sinks. So we use some beryllium oxide washers here. These green colors are beryllium oxide washers that will transfer only heat and also provides insulation. Okay, real images for the rectangular type of power transistor heat sink and circular or fin type of heat sink. So we can see these fin type heat sinks in CPUs. In desktops, we use this type of heat sink. So over this heat sink, we have a fan also. Okay, this is the power transistor diagram. So here you can observe the number for this power transistor is 2N3055, and here at the back side of this we can observe that there are only two leads. One is for base, another one is for emitter. So where is the collector? That is attached to this metal case. So this entire metal case is the collector terminal. So if you are attaching this type of power transistor to our heat sinks, definitely we have to use beryllium oxide washer between this case and this heat sink. Hope you understood. I will recall this topic in our interaction session. If you have any doubts, you can ask in the interaction session, or else you can directly WhatsApp me. Thank you.